There is new information about a serious bus crash that sent more than three dozen people to area hospitals.
A truck driver's dashboard camera shows the bus slamming into the concrete median of I-64 near the Jefferson-Shelby County line. WLKY's Matt McCutcheon is live at University Hospital with the latest on the victim's conditions and what we're learning about the charter bus company. Matt?
Well, Rick and Vicki, I just got on the phone with hospital officials. They tell me that seven people still remain hospitalized tonight, six of them here at University Hospital, one of them at Cosier Children's Hospital. While they are all expected to make it, several of them have major injuries to overcome, including broken bones.
Hurting, and like I said, his nose is broke, and we have bruised ribs.
Parents like Victoria Mux-Gawley explained the physical injuries her teenage son suffered. Emotionally, the pain is even more intense after this charter bus crashed Tuesday afternoon. This dash cam taken by trucker Lynn Wheeling shows the impact.
I wasn't thinking of anything else but making sure everybody was okay.
Commonwealth Bus Service and Transportation owns and operates the bus, but no one answered at their Louisville office today. State records with the company date back to 2006 and list the operation to be, quote, satisfactory. Few details are known about the bus driver, but investigators believe a mechanical issue is to blame. 42 people were rushed to the hospital, many of them on this.
It's an ambulance multiplied, yes.
This ambulance bus is used in situations like Tuesday to transport several patients at once, helping to free up nearly 10 ambulances.
You can take roughly 20 patients laying down. You can take somewhere between 25 patients that are sitting.
Louisville was one of the first cities to invest in the bus 2 years ago.
The walls are eraser boards, so you can take dry erase and write on the walls exactly what's going on with the patient, any changes or anything like that.
And those patients' families are just happy that no one died from this horrific crash.
It was really scary.
While those seven people continue to recover, we've learned that future educational field trips like that that were planned this week for Northern Kentucky University and Sullivan University have all been canceled. Live at University Hospital tonight at 6, I'm Matt McCutcheon, WLKY News.
Thanks, Matt. The students were all from Wagner High School. They were on their way back from a college tour at Eastern Kentucky University. Louisville police tell WLKY the crash resulted in another accident, creating further traffic delays on both sides of the interstate.